नमस्ते, वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन जीएसएम आर्किटेक्चर एंड सिग्नलिंग प्रोटोकॉल आर्किटेक्चर। लर्निंग आउटकम। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई डिफरेंट एंटिटीज इन जीएसएम आर्किटेक्चर एंड स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब द जीएसएम आर्किटेक्चर। दीज आर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ वीडियो लेक्चर। GSM stands for Global System for Mobile Communication. It is a digital cellular technology used for transmitting mobile voice and data services. The concept of GSM emerged from a cell-based mobile radio system at Bell Laboratories in early 1970s. It is a second-generation digital mobile telephone standard. Time division multiple access is used with frequency division multiple access, and GSM also provides 9.6 kbps data connection. Separate uplink and downlink frequencies are used in GSM. Features which are included: telephony, fax, SMS. These are new features which are included in GSM architecture or second generation standard, second generation GSM standard. Pause video for 2 minutes and list all frequency bands which are used for GSM network. I think 2 minutes are over. I should tell answer of this. GSM operates on the mobile communication band 900 megahertz and 1800 megahertz in most parts of the world. In US, GSM operates in the band 850 megahertz and 1900 megahertz. The band for the GSM which is used in US is different from rest of the world. GSM system architecture consists of three major subsystems. First subsystem is base station subsystem, second one is network and switching subsystem, and last one operation switching subsystem. The GSM technical specifications define the different elements within the GSM network architecture. It defines the different elements and the ways in which they interact to enable the overall system operation to be maintained. We can observe detailed architecture of GSM. Let us see function of each element in architecture. First element, that is base station subsystem. Again, the base station subsystem has three different elements. The base station subsystem section of GSM network architecture that is fundamentally associated with communicating with the mobiles on the network. It consists of first one mobile station, base station, and base transceiver station. First element of BSS, that is mobile station. Mobile stations, mobile equipment, they are most widely known as a cell or mobile phones, are section of a GSM network that the user sees and operates. There are number of elements to the cell phone, although the two main elements are the main hardware and the SIM. It also contains a number known as the International Mobile Equipment Identity Number, that is IMEI number. This is installed in the phone at a manufacturer and cannot be changed. The SIM or subscriber identity module contains information that provides the identity of the user to the network. It contains variety of information including a number known as the International Mobile Subscriber Identity Number, that is IMSI number. BTS, Base Transceiver Station. The BTS used in a GSM network comprises the radio transmitter receiver and their associated antennas that transmit and receive to directly communicate with the mobiles. The BTS is the defining element for each cell. The base station transceiver communicates with the mobiles, and the interface between the two is known as the UM interface with the associated protocols. BSC, that is base station controller. The function of BSC is the BSC forms the next stage back into the GSM network. It controls a group of BTS and is often co-located with one of the BTSs in its group. It manages the radio resources and controls items such as handover within the group of BTS, allocates channels and like. It communicates with the BTS, that is base station transceiver, or what is termed the ABS interface. The BSC forms the next stage back into the GSM network. It controls a group of base station. It manages the radio resources and controls items such as handover within the group, allocates channels, and it communicates with the base transceiver stations or what is termed as the ABS interface. Next subsystem is NSS, that is network and switching subsystem. The GSM system architecture contains a variety of different elements and is often termed as core network. It provides the main control and interfacing for the whole mobile network. The major elements within the core network include MSC, that is mobile switching center, HLR, that is home location register, VLR, that is visitor location register, AUC, that is authentication center, EIR, that is equipment identity register. The first element within a network subsystem is MSC, that is mobile switching center. The main element within the core network area of the overall GSM network architecture is the mobile switching center. The MSC acts like a normal switching node within the PSTN or ISDN, but also provides additional functionality to enable the requirements of a mobile user to be supported. These include registration, authentication, call location, inter MSC handover, and call routing to the mobile subscriber. It also provides an interface to the PSTN so that calls can be routed from the mobile networks to a phone connected to a landline. Interfaces to other MSCs are also provided to enable calls to be made to mobiles on different network. HLR, home location register. This database contains all the administrative information about each subscriber along with their last known location. In this way, the GSM network is able to route calls to the relevant base station for the MS. When a user switches on their phone, the phone registers with the network, incoming call can be routed appropriately. Even when the phone is not active or it is switched off, it re-registers periodically to ensure that the network is aware of its latest position. There is one HLR per network, although it may be distributed across various subcenters for operational reasons. VLR, that is visitor location register. This contains selected information from the HLR that enables the selected services for the individual subscriber to be provided. The VLR cannot be implemented as separate entity, but it is commonly realized as an integral part of the MSC rather than a separate entity. In this way, access is made faster and more convenient. Few part of database is also stored in VLR, like a TMSI number or roaming number. When mobile station visits another location, the temporary database is formed in a VLR. AUC, that is authentication center. Function of this component from NSS is to provide authentication for verification of the subscriber identity, ensures confidentiality of each cell, and protect from fraud call. EIR, that is equipment identity register. The EIR is the entity that decides whether a given mobile equipment may be allowed onto the network. Each mobile equipment has number known as the International Mobile Equipment Identity. This number, as mentioned above, is installed in the equipment and is checked by the network during the registration. Dependent upon the information held in the EIR, the mobile may be allocated on of three states: allowed onto the network, bad access, or monitored in case it's problem. OSS, operation and support subsystem. The OSS or operation support subsystem is an element within the overall GSM network architecture that is connected to components of the NSS and the BSC. It is used to control and monitor the overall GSM network, and it is also used to control the traffic load of the base station. It must be noted that as the number of base station increases within the scaling of the subscriber population, some of the maintenance tasks are transformed to the base stations, allowing saving in the cost of the ownership of the system. Now, last part of this video lecture, signaling protocol architecture. GSM architecture is a layered model that is designed to allow communications between two different systems. The lower layer assures the service of the upper layer protocol. Each layer passes suitable notifications to ensure the transmitted data has been formatted and received accurately. Based on the interface, the GSM signaling protocol is assembled into three general layers. Layer 1, the physical layer, it uses the channel structures over the air interface. Layer 2, the data link layer. Across the UM interface, the data link layer is a modified version of the link access protocol for the D channel protocol used in ISDN, called link access protocol on the DM channel. Across A interface, a message transfer part, that is MTP, layer 2 of SS7 is used. Layer 3, GSM signaling protocols, third layer is divided into three sub-layer. First layer is radio resource management, also called as RR layer. Mobility management, also called as a MM layer. Connection management, also called as CM layer. These are references. Thank you.